and then put it together and make a switch. It's a really good idea. Hey, Measuring Hero, Jay here. I'm here talking to Rolf, who is the product manager for horizontal arm machines, and we're talking about different ways to measure big stuff. Rolf.
Hi, Jay.
My first question is, we've seen some big gantry CMMs. These look totally different. Why do they look so different?
We have to look closer to the application, what we attack here. These CMMs are mainly designed for automotive industry to measure huge body-in-white systems, and the need is that we can measure above the roof, inside the body, the roof area. We can measure the underbody from the top, so we have to measure inside the body, above the body, but we have to measure the underbody of the car as well, and this is only possible with that design.
Okay, so these were really made to go inside and underneath.
Yes.
Underneath a car. These look a little different than some of the ones I've seen. They have some interesting design differences. Any reason why some of these, can you tell us a little bit about some of these?
Yes, we wanted to optimize the relation between stiffness and weight of the CMMs, because weight is a very critical factor in the safety of the machines, so we had to drop down the weight, but we had to keep the stiffness, because the stiffness defines the repeatability and the accuracy of the machines.
Cool. So yeah, it's a cool looking wedge too, wedge design. I've also noticed that we have some optical sensors on these back here. Is that something, a trend that you've seen with the use of these machines?
Yes. There's a very huge trend to optimize the measuring performance of the machine and to optimize the application. So traditionally, with this type of CMMs, we did measure tactile elements like bores, edge points, or single surface points. But nowadays, we want to measure the features very fast, but we have to measure complete areas as well. And this is only possible with an optical scanner, that we can measure complete areas. We can extract the position and the diameter of the features, but we can do a CAD compare of the complete areas as well.
Cool. So full CAD comparison of. I also noticed there's two of these. Can these work simultaneously?
Yes. Typically, both of the arms are working on the same workpiece, so they are optimized that there's no crash or things like this, but they do it simultaneously and they report the complete results into the same measuring report. So the operator or the guy who needs the report knows exactly how big is the component, and at the end we are talking about one single measuring report, not two.
Perfect. And I guess for me, are there any trends that you've seen in this type of with this type of measuring that are really you've seen that most customers are asking for something important?
Yeah, especially there's a big trend away from the OEMs itself. They try to move the parts to the first tiers, but they are forced to provide the measuring reports to the OEMs as well. So they have to measure very fast, very precise, and with the same report structure and into the same database as the OEM. And therefore, the first tiers, they need the same equipment as the OEMs have.
Okay, I see. Great, can we see one work? Go have a look at one?
Yes, of course.
Rolf, thank you for showing me the machine and for the wonderful conversation. Really appreciate it.
You're welcome.
All right, thanks.
Take care.
And for you, thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next Thursday.